First, let's take a look at the Civil Explorer. Here we have a drawing that has many different surfaces, alignments, and volume surfaces already loaded. If I expand the tin surfaces, you'll see this long list. Right-click on a surface and you have options to zoom to or select that surface. Clicking on the visibility button switches the surface on and off, either individually or as a group. This new visibility option applies to other features as well, like alignments or profiles. To build a tin surface from a DWG, we can just go to the Civil Explorer. Right-click on Tin Surfaces and pick Create. And then all we need to do is select whichever 3D objects we want to add to the surface. Once we select those, down at the command prompt, BricsCAD recognizes that we have some linear objects and wants to know whether we want to treat them as breaklines. In our case, we'll do breaklines, and we can see that it builds a surface for us automatically. Now we'll see that we don't have the edges of this surface cleaned up. That's because we didn't add a boundary. If we expand tin surfaces in the Civil Explorer and pick the surface we just created, we can right-click and see the options we have to edit, either adding a boundary from a 2D polyline, deleting individual lines manually, or having the option to remove outer edges. If we select this option, down at the command prompt, it asks for whether I want to specify a maximum triangle length, and I'm going to say yes. Type in a value or just pick something graphically off the screen. And you can see it's starting to clean up the edges, but it doesn't look quite as we want it to yet. So back in the Civil Explorer, with the surface selected, you can go to Definitions and it shows all of the operations we use to create the surface. And here's the Remove Outer Edges command that we use. Double click on that and it shows us the value that we input for the maximum edge. This can be changed, so change it to 100 and yes, that will do. Next, we can head to Visual Styles, turn off the triangles and turn on contours. Break lines are still visible here. They're the ones in yellow. And if I went back to the definition and double clicked on add break lines, we could see a list of all the break lines that were selected when we created the surface, along with other information like minimum and maximum elevations. If I wanted to find one of these break lines, all I have to do is right click on it and I can zoom to it or select it. There's also the option to select from the screen. Select a break line and it'll scroll to it in the dialog. Once it's selected, you could stretch it around and see how the surface changes with your edits. You could also right click on it in the list and pick remove. Now this removes it as a break line and you'll see the contours update dynamically, but it still leaves a line in the drawing if we need it for other purposes. Let's have a look at how these concepts work when working with really large data sets like point clouds. Here we have a point cloud attached to a drawing. This point cloud has 6.4 million points, which isn't necessarily huge, but still, we don't want to use all of them. Right-click on tin surfaces and pick Create, just like we did before. But this time, at the command line, we're going to select Create from Point Cloud. Pick the point cloud and hit Enter. Down at the command line, we're asked if we want to simplify the tin surface, and we'll definitely say yes. When it builds the tin, it then asks me for information like radius and elevation, and uses these values to filter out those points that fit in those parameters. So we can start the process, and pretty quickly it runs through all 6.4 million points, does filtering, and also gives a quick report back at the command line. Let's create the tin surface. Let's hide the point cloud so we can see just the tin surface. And although it looks pretty smooth overall, if we zoom in and look at this area, this road, we can see some areas that really need more data. Let's zoom in on this area, and in the Civil Explorer, I'll expand the tin surface. Pick the surface, and under the definition, you can see the very first option was to add point cloud. Double click on that, It shows us the parameters that were used when the surface was created. We could edit these here and BricsCAD would reprocess the entire surface. But we also have this option to densify the surface. Click that, and then we have an option to add a new area. Once you click that, down on the command line, it asks for a new elevation distance. Type that in, and then the next prompt is to apply this to the entire surface or just a specific area. So draw a polygon around this area, hit enter, and note you see it in the dialog on the right. Once an area is in there, the rebuild button goes live. So once you have all your areas, click rebuild and it'll go and look at the original point cloud, look at every single point in the point cloud and to see whether those points need to be added back into our surface. If you highlight the surface, you'll notice the change in density. We can cancel out of our dialog once we're happy, and if we zoom in and pan around, we'll see the road looks much better in that area. The enhancements in V23.2 make it even easier for civil engineers and surveyors to supercharge their workflows, giving you all the tools you need without the complication you don't.